How'd you feel first day back?
It felt all right. It's still, you know, it's still bugging me a bit, but it was nice to get out there and run, and feeling okay on it. We'll still day to day. I'm gonna try it out tomorrow and make a decision for the game tomorrow, but you know, it was a little better than I thought it was going to be, so that's good news, and it is a lot better than last week, so I'm positive about that, optimistic.
You did shut it down a little early. Is that just as a precaution, or did anything flare up at it?
Yeah, that was the plan. We were just going to test it out for a couple plays, do all the warm-up stuff, and kind of see how it reacted from there, because we don't want to push it too early and make it worse, so... And like I said, we'll just see how it is tomorrow and try to go a little harder tomorrow and do full speed practice. And then if I feel like I can be effective on the field, we're going to play in Calgary. And you know, but I don't want to hurt the team and take up a spot for somebody else. So it'll be a decision made tomorrow.
How frustrating has this been already that you're on the injured list just 3 games in?
Yeah, it's tough, and it's never easy with an injury. It's the nature of the business, though, and it's definitely something that it could have been a lot worse, so I'm fortunate that it only is what it is. I just want to, you know, be effective when I get back out there and not be limping around, so that's kind of why we're making sure it's okay and not trying to push through it, but it is frustrating, you know, when coming down the stretch and we need these games badly, so I want to be out there with the guys for sure.
You know the offense, and you know Darian and whatnot, but is it? But does missing a week cause any kind of problems?
Mm-hmm. No. We're still mentally engaged. We've been through meetings and watched the film, and I get a lot of extra stuff on my own too. So I don't think we'll miss a beat if we get back out there.
Well, he tested it. He wasn't able to cut and didn't have the comfort on it that he needs to have in order to play well. So we're going to try it again tomorrow and see how he is tomorrow.
If he can't go, what's kind of the game plan that way?
Well, we're probably going to have to make some adjustments in our receiving core, and we're going to talk about that this afternoon, just how we're going to go about that.
Couple of other injuries to update, Jarrell Freeman, first of all.
Jarrell Freeman, he had a little tweak in his hamstring yesterday, and we had him not practice today. He probably could have practiced today, but again, we wanted to be cautious. I told him before practice, it's a lot more important for him to be ready for the game than to come out here and do what we're doing here today.
Dallas Baker.
That was a little more serious than what I first thought, maybe what we all first thought. But he still had a headache this morning, and so we're going to see how he is tomorrow. And that maybe comes in and comes into play when we talk about our receiving core altogether. So we'll just have to see how that is tomorrow.
Does he have a concussion?
Well, he has some symptoms. You know, he had a headache yet this morning. So whether that's concussion or just a headache, I don't know, but we'll go through the concussion protocols and that's to make sure that he's ready to play if he does play.
Shulgin
is going to be fine. He has had a little bit of tenderness, and he came out here and he did way more yesterday than he probably should have done, and so he was tender this morning, and again, just to give him a day of rest, he'll be good to go in the game.